Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So today I am going to explain about the common terms used for describing muscles and vessels. Now moving on to the first one, that is about the muscles. Under muscles today I am going to explain about what is origin, what is insertion, what is belly, what is tendon, what is aponeurosis, what is raphe, and the last one, that is ligaments. Now moving on to the first one, what is origin? Origin means the end of the muscle which fixed during contraction. When the muscle contract, one end of the muscle, if it is fixed, that is called as origin. The next one we call as insertion. Insertion means the end of the muscle which moves during contraction. When the muscle contract, an end, if it is moving, that part is called as insertion. Okay. Origin and insertion, which are commonly used in the muscles of anatomy. Okay. The next one is called as belly. What is belly? Belly means, as you can see in the diagram, it is a fleshy, contracted part of the muscle. And tendon. What is tendon? Tendon means these are fibrous, non-contractile, cord-like structure. Okay. In the diagram, you can see the belly, which is fleshy and contractile in the center. The fibrous, non-contractile, cord-like structure on either side of the belly, that is called as tendon. Now moving on to something called as aponeurosis. Aponeurosis means these are flattened tendon. Example for that is epicranial aponeurosis of the scalp. The next one, that is called as raphe. Raphe means these are fibrous, non-elastic, and especially formed by the interdigitating fibers of tendons or aponeurosis. Okay, and this raphe you will be studying in the anterior triangle. Fibrous raphe in the submental triangle. The last one, that is called as ligaments. Ligaments means these are fibrous, these are non-elastic, and especially connecting the two segments of joints. So that's all about the terms used for describing muscles. Now moving on to the terms used for explaining vessels. Under that, first one, what is artery, what is vein, what is venae cavitans, what is capillary, what is sinusoid, and what is anastomosis. These are the things which I am going to explain it. Now moving on to the first one, what is artery? How can I define artery? Artery means they carry blood away from the heart. Okay. So if they are carrying blood away from the heart, that is called as artery. Artery usually carry oxygenated blood. But there are exceptions for this, that is the umbilical artery and pulmonary artery usually carry deoxygenated blood. The second one is called as vein. What is vein? Vein usually carry deoxygenated blood, and it is carrying towards the heart. Okay, so veins are carrying blood towards the heart, usually carry deoxygenated blood. But there are exceptions for this also, that is the pulmonary vein and umbilical vein, both of them are carrying oxygenated blood. The next one, what is venae cavitans? So venae cavitans, you can see in the diagram. Okay, so there are two veins, one on each side of the medium sized artery. This you can see especially in the lumps, and this is connected each other across the artery. So this is called as venae cavitans, and this venae cavitans especially you can see in the lumps. The next one is called as capillaries. So what is capillaries? These are microscopic network of vessels which connect an arteriole to venule. So that is called as capillary. Okay. The next one is called as sinusoid. So what is sinusoid? Sinusoid means these are large, irregular vascular spaces which are surrounded by the parenchyma of an organ. Especially you can see in the liver, adrenal gland, etc. like that. Okay. The next one, that is called as anastomosis. So what is this anastomosis? Anastomosis means the pre-capillary or post-capillary communication between the vessels, that is called as anastomosis. So in the diagram we can see the communication between the pre-capillary and post-capillary. Okay, pre-capillary or post-capillary. Okay, so that's all about today's video. So that is about the common terms used for explaining the muscles and vessels. And the next video I'll be explaining about the definition of bone and the function of bone and the growth structure of an adult long bone. So these topics are very important, and please have a look on that. So that's all about today's video, and thank you so much.